hate this place. You got no freedom here. I don't deserve to be stuck in this hole, being gawked at by Conan there. And this food, they expect me to eat this? God, this stuff stinks. Say, what's this thing with a hole in it?
I thought they were supposed to throw this part of the animal away. You having a good time? This is fun for you, huh? Listen, you know, I'm gonna be getting out of here. And when I do, I think you and I are gonna get together with a couple friends of mine.
Well, that's it for another day, huh? Just lock up the con and go home to the wife. Another day, another dollar, eh? Well, I don't know how you can sleep at night knowing an innocent man is in jail. I was framed and you know it! You get back here and open this door immediately. I'm warning you, I'll sue you and everybody else in this whole damn place.
Yeah, well, who needs you? Because I can make out just fine on my own. Hello? Well, I see you found a new way in. Hello, God? Can you hear me? Listen, I got something to tell you. I don't belong here. I was framed. Now, you probably know that, but, just in case you were busy healing lepers or something when all this was going down, let me tell you what really happened.
Great. have your rent money yet?
Well, no, but I do have a job interview this morning. If I can...
Can it? You fed me that crap long enough, and I'm not going to take it anymore. If you don't have the $400 you owe me by Monday, you're out!
But, Mom...
Well, Hitler would have loved this broad. During my trial, the prosecution called her as a witness. I don't know why, me being an innocent man and all. Anyway, when she took the stand, you could hear a pin drop in the place. Even the judge had to do a double take. She's wearing this frilly green dress right out of the 50s. Musical notes all over it. And her makeup looked like she put it on with a cattle prod, you know? Well, it was then that I began to feel sorry for the kid. I mean, could you imagine having to be breastfed by that thing? Well, it kind of gives you the creeps, don't it? Anyway, the interview the kid had was with me.
There's a lady coming.
Now, before you go feeling sorry for this kid, let me just tell you something, okay? He wasn't the only one starting the day off on the wrong foot. I mean, my hairdryer went on the fritz, and a couple other things happened, so I was having a bad day too. But neither of us were having as bad a day as my old buddy, Nicky Fortunatus.
Hey, when that lawyer of mine gets here, send him right in.
Yes, sir. Yes, just one moment, please. Yo, excuse me, Mr. Fortunatus. It's your aunt holding on line one.
Well, get rid of her.
It's the fourth time the old bag has called this morning. She wants to speak to you. I can't hold her off any longer.
What do you want? Oh, come on, don't be such a geriatric old wimp. Well, that's not my problem. Listen, it's as simple as this. You haven't paid your rent, so I had your furniture seized. It's perfectly legal. Now, don't bother calling here again till you got the money you owe me. You old bitch. You idiot. What kind of lawyer are you, anyhow?
Well,
nothing. Simple foreclosure, no problems, you said. Go ahead and sell the nightclub. It'll all work out in the wash. Some wash. Our bloody laundry's dirtier now than when we put it in.
Look, how was I supposed to know the dame that you sold the club to was going to put up a fight? None of the other ones did.
That's a silk tie. Get off it.
Oh, my leg went dead.
Sorry to bother you, Mr. Fortunatus. Mr. Wagner, he's holding on line two. He says it's urgent.
Wagner? Do you think he knows I don't own the nightclub I sold him?
Oh, not a chance. If he did, he'd be at the door with a couple of cops not calling you on the phone.
And what do you think he wants?
How should I know? But look, you gotta stall for time. You're gonna need at least a couple of weeks to sort this mess out, huh?
Give me the phone.
Come on in, Bob. How are you today?
Well, not too bad, thank you. And yourself?
I'm fine.
Say, Nicky, I was calling to see if I could pop around and pick up the deed to the club.
Yeah, I got some bad news for you, Bob. We've had some plumbing problems at the club, and it's going to take at least 2 weeks to repair them.
All right, Fortunatus, this is the last delay I'm going to put up with anymore, and I'll be asking for my money back.
But what can I do about it? These things happen, and I'm not going to let you have the club until it's in tip-top shape.
All right, but I'll be calling you in 2 weeks' time, and you better have the papers ready or else. Listen, son, I know I promised not to ask you for any special treatment, but could you check this guy out? Things aren't working out the way they should. I'm starting to get worried.
Sure, Dad. If it'll make you feel better.
Two brains in her head. She'd have seen right there and then that this kid was nothing but trouble and turfed him out in the street.
If that stuff in your hand is moose, I'd be awfully careful with that cigarette if I was you.
Why?
Because it'll blow your face off, that's why.
I better get rid of this stuff. Why don't you grab a seat, Mr.
Nelson? Willard Nelson?
Well, just grab a seat.
Do you mind if I just...
Hey, hold on to these. I want you to run this down to the cleaner for me. Tell the bums I want it back by 4, huh?
And don't try anything stupid, or the immigration people will get a little call from me.
Oh! That's it. You're fired. I've told you 1,000 times not to leave your junk scattered around in here.
Excuse me, this seems to be a slight misunderstanding.
Who the hell are you?
Willard Nelson.
Uh-huh.
That was my guitar case you tripped over, not some junk of your secretary's. I hope you forgive me.
Oh, yeah, I forgive you. Now pack up your junk and get the hell out of here.
But
nothing. I'm going to the can now, and when I get back, you're gone. And you clean this mess up.
Pretty good book, Henry. You ought to give it a read sometime. Henry? Henry? Henry! You know, Henry, sometimes I think you're not really listening to me. Well,
God, I don't know if anything like that's ever happened to you, but let me tell you, it was awful. I don't even want to talk about it. But I will say this. No matter what came out in court, I still think it was the kid's fault. I mean, if he hadn't have worn Babs, she'd have the smoking butt, not me. Yeah. So why they're peeling me off the ceiling? Nikki and that white-shoed lawyer of his, they put their two pea-sized brains together trying to figure something out.
Want a shot?
No, no, thank you.
And where do we stand with this girl?
Well, as of today, she's managed to raise about half of what she owes you.
So, she got any hopes of raising the rest by Monday?
Well, under normal circumstances, no, but she's been on the phone talking to every booking agent in town.
Huh?
Trying to find a band who will play on spec. Well, you know the way musicians are. Who knows? Maybe she'll get lucky.
Then we just have to do something about that, won't we?
Oh, no, 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 no. It's not we, it's you.
What?
Oh, I'm finished. This whole thing's getting too sordid.
Sordid?
Yeah, I'm gonna take a couple of weeks off. Maybe go ice fishing, wash my hands of the whole mess before I get, say, disbarred.
If that's the way you want to play it, fine. But I got a good friend who's a booking agent. When he hears the predicament I'm in, he won't hesitate to help me.
Well, lucky you.
Well, I guess by now you know the friend he was talking about was me.
Huh, Henry?
Say, do you mind if I smoke? What a silly question. I mean, if you didn't want people to use this stuff, you wouldn't have invented it, right? Well, what can I tell you? It's a non-smoking wing. I gotta hide the stuff. Now, where was I? Oh, yeah. Nikki and his problem. You see, he used to roll its club over 4 or 5 times a year. Always the same old story. He'd find somebody with enough money for a down payment, but couldn't afford to run the place once they took possession. Then as soon as they missed a payment, he was on them like lice. He'd foreclose so fast on these chumps, they wouldn't even know what hit him. Kind of like me in the can, you know? Whammo! You're down for the 10 count. The other guy trots off scot-free.
No, but I think I found out what happened to that old horse they used to keep tethered out back of here.
Oh, how you been?
You know.
Yeah, I know. Broke, unemployed, and probably still living with those two freaks you call parents.
Well...
Listen, why don't we have something to eat? Forget it. Treat's on me.
Okay, and next time it's my turn to buy.
Great. Now you can fill me in on everything that's happened to you while I've been gone.
You talking to me? By the way, I must say, you're looking good tonight. So what this schmo is doing out free is beyond me. I mean, there are guys doing hard time for less than what he did to me. Huh, Henry? Yeah, so there he is, sitting in this fancy restaurant with his big face hanging out, cracking jokes and having fun with a good-looking chick, all at my expense.
Excuse me, are you finished with your plates?
Mm.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Welcome.
Could I get another cup of coffee, please?
So, did he blow his... off?
No, he just toasted his buns. He'll be all right.
What are you gonna do now?
Guess I'll have to find another agent.
I mean about a place to live.
I don't know, maybe I'll get lucky and get kidnapped by a roving band of nymphomaniacs.
Goo. I'm serious.
I honestly don't know. Sometimes I just wish I was dead. I wouldn't have to put up with all this crap.
Don't even think that way. I'm surprised at you. You've always had a lot of talent. And one thing you've never been is a quitter.
I know, I just can't take any more of this life. Wish I could trade it in on a new one.
Listen, if your parents chuck you out, they'll be doing you a big favor. And don't worry about a place to stay. You can always come stay with me. Oh gosh, look at the time. I gotta get going or my boss is gonna kill me. Here, my phone isn't connected yet. If you need a friend, you can always call me at work.
Okay. Carmen. There's something else.
I ran that 40-41 you wanted.
What'd you find out?
How much is it worth to you?
Come on, hand it over. I don't have time to play your stupid games.
You gotta stop taking this job so seriously.
Well, who'd have guessed? This guy's a real weasel.
Yeah, it's amazing he's managed to stay in business as long as he has.
It's because he's never been convicted of any of these charges that have been brought up.
What's your interest in this guy, anyway?
My dad bought a nightclub off him.
Where's this place located?
Kill him.
Kill him? Hey, that's a rough little town. My brother-in-law lived there for a while. He used to drive one of those little red MG sports cars. And everyone in town, even the little kids, little babies in jean jackets, used to call him a homo. Until he put a gun rack in the back window.
Get serious. I don't know. The documents are all legal, but the guy's been delaying in the transfer of the deed. This whole place could just exist on paper. As far as I know, my father's never been there. He could just be taking this Mr. Fortunatus guy at his word.
That seems to be a dangerous thing to do.
I know. But before I tell my dad, I think I'm gonna do a little more research into this whole affair.
Sounds like a good idea to me.
Hey.
May I help you?
Yeah, I'm here to see Larry Harris.
You got an appointment?
No, I don't. Hey, listen. Just get on the phone and tell Larry that Nicky Fortunatus is here to see him.
Okay. Yes, may I please have the number of the university hospital?
What kind of game are you playing?
No game. Mr. Harris was taken to the hospital this morning, and I don't know when he'll be released.
Then just give me his room number.
I'm afraid I don't have his room number. Look. All I know is he was taken out of here in a stretcher this morning and headed to the hospital. And like I said, I don't know when he'll be back. That's all.
You're lucky you don't work for me, chickie.
Me too, you jerk.
You know, when I look back on it now, I find it sort of amazing how all our lives interconnected. I mean, when I was in the hospital being tended to by Florence of the SS, Nikki, the cop, Babs, the girl, the kid, and me were all being drawn together in some strange sort of way.
Hey, you know what room Larry Harris is in?
Let's see. Harris? Harris. Oh, yeah. That's the buttock case.
Buttock.
Yeah, you just have to go over there and ask that nurse where the guy with the buttock is.
Maybe if you want
to. Hey, do you know where the guy with the buttock is?
Would that be one buttock or two?
Hey, I'm not here to play any games. Just show me where the guy with the buttock is.
You know, believe it or no, we got a lot of guys with buttocks in here. Now, if you gave me a name, maybe I could help you.
Harris.
Pardon?
Harris, the guy's name is Harris, Larry Harris.
Well, now that's better. He's just around the corner.
Oh!
Don't even ask.
Haven't lost your sense of humor, Larry.
Yeah, what can I do for you, Nicky?
What are you talking about? I heard you were laid up when I come to pay a little visit.
Cut the crap. You didn't even visit your mother, unless it was to collect the rent.
Oh, come on. I'm not that bad.
Now, I can honestly tell you, God. By the way, you don't mind me calling you that, do you? I mean, do you have a last name, or is that all she wrote? Okay, God it is. Anyway, I really wasn't in the mood to see Nikki just at that time. Well, you can imagine, there I was laying with my butt burnt to the crisp. This guy thinks I did it as a joke.
There is something you can do to help me, yeah. You know that nightclub of mine in Killam?
Yeah, sure. As a matter of fact, I just got a call the other day from the last sucker you sold that place to.
Yeah, well, that's why I'm here. Yeah. I want to stop that dame from booking a band in that club.
Yeah?
I need your help to gum up the works. It's her only chance to make the money she owes me, and if she succeeds, my goose is really cooked. Hey, what's so funny about that?
You're just a tad late, because I just heard she's booked a pretty good band in there for tomorrow night.
Damn. What am I gonna do now?
Oh, jeez. There's always something you can do if the price is right. Can you believe that? This guy, supposedly my best buddy, clobbering me in the shoulder like that when I'm laying there helpless? Well, anyway, you know the real ridiculous thing? I wasn't even thinking about him right then. I was thinking about this goofy joke I heard about the moron who goes to France. You must have heard it. The guy goes to France, right? And he has trouble scoring with the chicks. So he goes to the swinger and he says, "Hey, listen, I'm not getting anywhere." Well, the swinger says, "No problem. Get a potato, put it down your swim trunks." Well, okay, he goes and finds the biggest potato he can possibly buy and shoves it in his bathing suit back down to the beach. He notices the chicks are staring at him, okay, but anytime he gets near them, they kind of move away real fast. So he goes back to the swinger and he says, "Hey, man, this ain't working, okay?" Well, the swinger stands back, takes one look at him, and he says, "You idiot, I told you to put the potato in the front of your bathing suit." Anyway, as ridiculous as that may sound, that joke gave me the idea for Nikki's solution.
Price. How much?
$5,000 in cash tomorrow, or I blow the whistle on you myself.
You're worse crook than I am. All right, the money's yours, but I'm not gonna forget this, Harris.
Hey, settle down, Fortunatus. You made the right decision. You won't regret it.
I better not. Now you're going down with me.
Do I look worried? Ask me why.
Why?
Because I've got the perfect solution to your problem.
Solution?
Yeah, now if you'd just do something useful for a change and hand me the phone book there in that drawer, huh?
Yes.
Yeah.
Sure.
Okay. I'll just take care of this.
You will be relieved of a burden not of your own making. Sure.
What the hell? Hey, what's the matter with that damn dog?
I don't know. He must have eaten something that didn't agree with him.
That's it. That's it. Now, if you get that mutt out of here before he leaves a trail from one end of this house to the other.
Then I'll put him downstairs.
Are you crazy? You just toss him outside.
Oh, come on. Mommy put you outside.
Hello?
Hello, Willard. Willard, my friend.
Mr. Harris, is that you?
Hey, no need to be so formal, kid. Just call me Larry.
Well, what can I do for you, Larry?
Well, you can say you'll take this great gig I found for you.
Excuse me, Larry, I'm a little confused. After that little episode this morning, I had the distinct impression you never wanted to see me again.
Hey, listen, forget this morning. I was upset, okay? I lost control. Anyway, that's neither here nor there. Now, do you want to hear about this gig or not?
Well,
great! Listen, you're going to love this gig. It's only a one-nighter and it's out of town, but it's a fantastic career move. And not only that, the money's great.
How much does it pay?
That's a good question, Willard. Just hold on a second and I'll check the contract for the correct amount. $500 plus expenses.
And who pays me?
The club owner will pay you as soon as you live up to your end of the bargain.
Come on now, Larry. You gotta be putting me on. This is some kind of joke,
no,
right?
No, not at all. I'm deadly serious. And I'm gonna tell you something now, Willard, and I want you to remember it, okay? A good businessman always puts business ahead of personal affairs.
But you haven't even heard me play yet. How do you know I'm any good?
I've got my sources, that's how. Now look, I'm waiting for an answer here, Willard. What's it gonna be? And remember, this is a chance of a lifetime.
Well, what kind of room is it? If it's a nightclub, there's no way I can do it. I haven't got a band right now. But I have enough equipment and material to play.
This is gonna work out even better than I thought.
So if that's the kind of act you want, maybe I can help you.
That's why I called you, Willard. It's a small lounge, but it's part of a bigger complex. The perfect showcase for your talents.
What the heck? Why not? I've got nothing to lose. But how do I get there?
You don't own a car?
It hasn't ran since the accident. Well, I guess that's the end of that.
No, not at all. Listen, trains go out there regularly.
That presents another problem. You seem a little short of cash right now.
Well, have you got a friend that can give you a lift out there?
Yeah, as a matter of fact, I do.
So, where is it we're going again?
Killam.
I've never even heard of it before.
It's a small town about 120 miles southeast of here.
Well, we'd better get a move on then.
No, there's no need to hurry. We don't have to be there until 6 o'clock.
How come so late?
I guess no one will be there before then.
Well, that doesn't give you much time to get set up.
Well, but what the heck? I can be fast about things when I have to. Remember how fast I ran when the football team found out it was me who laced the cheerleader's popcorn with laxative?
That's right. I hear they're still a little sore over that one.
Okay. Oh, do you want me to drive?
No, that's fine. I could use some directions, though.
Okay, let's get a move on.
Oh,
just what it means to me. I still care too much to let it pass by. Won't you let me look into your eyes? Listen to my, listen to my desire.
Such a great opportunity. Look who's playing in the main room.
Jeez, and I think the first time I met that Larry Harris,
there
I thought
he
was...
There you go. You can't judge people on first impressions.
What a smart ass. Could you take my guitar, please?
Door's locked.
It's 6:05, there should be somebody in there. Listen, could you wait here and keep an eye on the equipment? I'll look around back and see if there's another way into this place.
Okay.
Confused us with somebody else. Oh, there's a lounge down at the hotel. Maybe he's supposed to be playing down there.
No, the agent who gave him this booking specifically said Cook County Saloon in Killam.
Well, there's only one way to settle this. Where is your boyfriend?
Oh, he just went around back to see if there was an open door.
How long has he been gone?
10 minutes.
He's probably found his way in by now. Come on. Here, I'll give you a hand with this.
Take another step, you pervert, you, and I'll shoot the boots. I'm warning you, I'll hoof you in the berries.
Listen, lady, all I want is the key to the front door. I'm playing in the lounge tonight. I just want to bring in my equipment.
Baloney. We don't have a lounge.
What?
That's right.
What on earth happened to you?
He tried to rape me.
I never did. All I wanted to do was get the key to the front door, that's all.
Baloney.
That's enough. Now you just finish up what you were doing here and then go home. And stay away from those dirty magazines. But nothing. Now, for you two. We're gonna go to my office and find out what's going on here. Right now. You can leave that here. It'll be all right.
Oh, the amp, yes, but not the guitar. This is my baby.
Well, whatever. Please excuse the mess, but things have been just crazy for me lately, and I haven't had a chance to clean up.
That's all right. I understand. Ow!
Are you all right?
Yeah, I'm fine. Thank you.
Are you sure you're all right?
Listen, why don't you do that after we have our little conversation? I'm expecting Willie Nelson here any minute. As a matter of fact, he's a little bit late. I was told he'd be here at exactly 6 o'clock and not a second sooner.
Excuse me, what agent booked Willie Nelson in here?
Larry Harris. Hello?
Hello, is Mr. Fortunatus there, please?
What is this? Some sort of a joke?
No, it isn't, and I'd appreciate it if you'd put Mr. Fortunatus on the line, please.
Listen, I don't know what the hell you're up to, mister, but Fortunatus isn't here, and if he was, I'd kick him out on his butt.
I'm a little confused. I thought Mr. Fortunatus owned that nightclub.
Who is this?
That's not important right now. Will you be there later this evening?
I'm thinking of taking a run out to kill him. I'd like to talk to you.
You bet I'll be here. But like I said, I'm going to be really busy.
But this just might be as important to you as it is to me.
Well, okay then. When you get here, just ask for Clara.
Excellent. We'll see you later.
So, where were we?
We were talking about Larry Harris.
Right. So why are you interested in him?
Because he was the agent who booked me in here.
Yeah, go on.
Well, I don't know quite how to put this, but it didn't even click with me until you said 6 o'clock and not a second sooner, because that's exactly what Larry Harris told me.
Can you just get to the point?
I never did introduce myself. My name's Willard Nelson, and I believe I'm your featured attraction.
You're good. You're very good.
I'm sorry, but I don't understand.
Oh, come on. You don't really expect me to believe that line you just handed me. Get serious. Now, whoever you are, I can take a joke with the best of them, but time is running out. So quit horsing around and go tell Willie to get in here and settle his contract.
I'm afraid he is serious. If you don't want to believe him, that's your problem.
What do you mean?
Yesterday morning, Willard had a run-in with Larry Harris, who, for whatever reason, revenge, I guess, booked him in here. And now you're in a jam. I'm afraid it's a horrible situation and almost unbelievable. That's the way it is.
I hope you rot in hell, Fortunatus. I had a feeling this all sounded too good to be true. You know, I even asked that damned agent, why on earth would Willie Nelson, a million-dollar entertainer, come out here to the middle of nowhere and play for expenses? But he was convincing. Remember Farm Aid, he said? Well, just think of this as Clara Aid. And I fell for it. Hook, line, and sinker. Damn it! My only hope of saving this place was tonight's concert, and now I've got to call the whole thing off. That's it. I'm finished. People have paid good money to come here tonight and see Willie Nelson, the greatest country singer who ever lived. And instead, I've got the Tin Man here.
Oh, no, wait a minute. That's uncalled for. Willard here is a very talented guy.
But you're not exactly Willie Nelson, are you?
Well...
But he could be.
What are you talking about?
He could be Willie Nelson.
What?
A few alterations, a change of clothes, and a little bit of makeup can totally transform someone. They do it in the movies all the time.
Are you off your nut? Just think what that crowd tonight would do if they found out they'd paid $25 a piece to see an imposter. They'd level this place to the ground.
I have thought about what might happen,
And it would be better than doing nothing at all.
You like this one, Henry? It's hot. Now, here was a twist that wasn't part of my scenario at all. This chick was trying to put the kibosh on all my hard work. She had no business sticking her nose in where it didn't belong. I'll bet I spent 2 hours on the phone with her, giving her all my best lines. But it wasn't until I mentioned Farm Aid and told her to think of it as Clara Aid that she finally bought the story and canceled the other band. But no, this wasn't supposed to be happening at all, you know? I mean, the kid was supposed to drive out there, be humiliated, leave Clara in the lurch, and drive away with his tail between his legs. Simplistic, but a masterpiece. But as it turned out in court, these dirty beggars were doing a little scheming of their own. What a bunch of buffoons. The kid's girlfriend was some kind of beautician or something, and she said she could do a Hollywood makeover on this idiot. And she knew some musician, Stewart, that lived nearby and thought maybe he'd be free. But here's the topper. The kid didn't know one of Willie Nelson's tunes. I mean, he'd have to learn them when he went out on stage.
The greatest band you've ever heard.
I mean, what gall? Can you believe these clowns?
Then I'd be willing to pay you the $12,000 that I was supposed to pay the other Willie Nelson. What would you say to that?
I'd say you've got yourself a deal.
Great. Then let's get to work. We've got a hell of a lot to do in the next 8 hours.
Let's get you tuned up.
I don't look the way the one dream about your love. I know everything about me is all wrong, but while your heart's still free, can't you look past what you see? Will I do till the real thing comes along? You don't dream about me when you go to sleep at
Nelson. We were wondering if you could tell us where we might find the rascal.
I heard he's having a drink with the owner in her office.
And where might that be?
Straight through those doors down there. By the band room. You can't miss it.
Hey, guys. They're probably going to start letting people in here right away, so we better sound check and tune out first. Then we'll check out Willie. Hate to be a pest, ma'am, but have you got somebody here to operate the sound equipment?
Mm-hmm. He's right over there.
Much obliged.
I think he needs a little more work on the eyebrows. Then he'll be perfect. Okay?
I've been tried and I'm true, but I ain't been tried by you. Please let your heart belong to me just temporarily.
Hey.
Though I know there'll come a day.
Thank you.
Anybody in there?
Stuart, is that you?
No, it's Waylon Jennings.
Well, we might as well see what he thinks. Tell him to come in.
Come on in.
I thought you were bringing more musicians with you.
Oh, they're busy chasing waitresses.
Say, I'd really like to thank you for showing up here tonight. You're a real lifesaver.
That goes for Willard and I, too.
Oh, no problem. It sounds like it's gonna be a real hoot. Well, you know how I like to party.
Yeah, well, what do you think?
I think Willard here's got more balls than I ever gave him credit for.
That's it. I'm not going out there.
Oh, yes, you are.
Who am I trying to kid anyway?
Everyone. And you're not going to chicken out on me now.
Oh.
Now, this should be interesting. It ain't over till the end. I may break, but I won't bend. I won't run, I'll face the gun.
I'm not going out there.
You don't have to. Just take a look.
It's just a short fall. Loser take all.
This isn't helping him. It's a tough looking crowd out there.
Let me see.
God. Did you see that guy in the front row?
Which one? There's lots of guys in the front row.
The one who looks like he just got kicked off a circus train.
Yeah, I see him. He's probably the bearer of Kill 'em.
See? Now how bad can it be with harmless people like that in the audience, huh?
Yeah, I guess you're right.
Damn, of all nights, why tonight? Do you know who showed up here tonight? The creep that's trying to weasel this place away from me, that's who. And he's up to no good, I tell you. Oh, why couldn't he have gotten a bad case of hemorrhoids and bled to death?
Why'd you have the bum thrown out?
Because he's already in here. And the last thing we need before we get started is a big scene. But keep your eye on that weasel. He's nothing but trouble.
Well, guess it's showtime. You ready, Willie?
Ready as I'll ever be.
Good. Now, who's gonna introduce Willie here?
I guess I should. But what do I say? I've never done anything like this before.
I don't know. But we'll play a little intro, and then you can come on out. I guess we'll just have to wing it from there. Good luck.
Showing up here tonight. You don't know how much this means to me. You came here to see someone very special. So without any further ado, I'd like to introduce the man who rewrote the book on country music, the one and only Mr. Willie Nelson. Woo!
There ain't even a gun in power.
person who threw this please stand up and identify yourself? Mom? Is that you? Hey, I thought you liked my act.
Why are you people laughing at this chucklehead? Why are you listening to this thing? He's a fraud. He's got something like a bunch of idiots. You ought to be getting mad and asking for your money back.
Why don't you sit down? I want to hear what this guy has to say. Sit down, cowboy.
Now, you people are owed an honest explanation, and you're going to get one. For starters, my name is Willard Nelson. And there are a number of very good reasons why I disguise myself as Willie Nelson. The most important is if I didn't, Clara Looney, the lady who owns this place, would lose it and everything she's worked for to that weasel with a megaphone. Just couldn't stand by and see that happen. Now, you're all entitled to your money back. But if you'd like to help Clara keep this place and are serious about having a good time tonight, give us a chance to entertain you. And if you're still around by midnight, and Clara will keep the money she's taken in and pay off the bum. And if not, then you'd have gotten your money back and the place will have a new owner. So what do you say? Should we let her rip?
Yeah!
You know that old Earl King tune, Come On, the way Hendrix used to do it?
Yeah? Are you sure that's the song you want to do?
Yeah, I'm sure.
Roll.
King Walter.
Did he write that?
Sure. Dun, 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 slow walking Walter.
So do you want to hear another one?
Yeah! Woo! Woo!
Well, who'd have thought the kid had any talent, you know? I mean, he was such a loser. And Nikki, well, he shows up at the club to take possession and do a little gloating over Clara's misfortune. Ends up smack in the middle of a nightmare. Hey, it was a rotten situation, but you can't blame me. I was just trying to help out a friend.
Pull here anyway.
Nothing. I just need your signature. Right here. Before I hand over the 5,000 I owe you.
I'll do no such thing.
I'm afraid you have no other option. Legally speaking, you have to take my money. Pleasure doing business with you.
Didn't anyone ever tell you it's rude to walk out on a performance? Especially one this good. You know, it's good to see the high caliber of talent around here. I think my dad is going to be quite pleased when he hears about that. Yeah, as a matter of fact, I think you know my dad. His name's Bob Wagner. Oh!
Starting to really tick me off with this silent routine, Henry. Anyway, Nicky's not in the cop car 2 minutes, and he starts acting mental. I mean, this guy should have been an actor. He really had that cop going, which would have been fine if the weasel hadn't told him I was the real mastermind behind this scheme, because the cop bought it. Can you believe that? Me, a respected businessman just trying to help out a friend in need, gets fingered as some sort of criminal kingpin. Well, Nicky shouldn't have done that, and you know it. Anyway, I guess the kid was a hit, and the crowd called him out for 3 encores before he finally got off the stage.
You know, Carmen, every time I look at you, I think, how can a decent, good-looking woman like you have anything to do with the likes of me?
because I've always known that you're not the loser everyone thinks you are. And you proved that beyond a shadow of a doubt tonight.
Sorry to interrupt you, lovebirds, but I've got someone here who wants to meet Willard.
Should I ask him in?
Sure, why not?
Mr. Brown? I'd like to introduce Don Brown.
How do you do?
Pleased to meet
you. With CHA, Artist Management in London, England. I just happened to be over here visiting some friends, and they insisted on bringing me down here this evening, and I'm glad they did. I think you've got a tremendous future in this business, and I'd like to have the opportunity to discuss it with you at a more appropriate time. My telephone number while I'm in this country is on the reverse side there. Please give me a call before next Friday if you're interested.
Pardon me for interrupting, but we've decided to throw a little party over at my place, and we were wondering if you'd all like to drop by.
Oh, well, I better be getting along. I hope to hear from you.
Pleased to meet you. Sorry, Stu, I'll have to pass.
Me too.
Yeah, draw me one. Jeez, I almost forgot. There you go, and you've earned every single penny of it.
Wait a minute, there's only 25 bucks here.
You gotta be kidding. Get out of here.
That's exactly what I intend to do.
So what are you gonna do with all that money?
Free myself of a burden which is not of my own making. See you in another life.
Well, what the hell is that supposed to mean?
Listen to this. He pleads insanity, gets 2 months in the nut house, gets released, and now he's a TV evangelist. And me, I end up here. Now I ask you, where is the justice? I mean, okay, so sometimes I have a bad temper and I blurt things out I shouldn't say, but how was I to know what I said about the judge's wife was true? She should be in here, not me. So come on, does the punishment really fit the crime here? So, what do you say? You gonna help me or not? Okay, you don't want to talk to me, fine. I know I'm not one of your regulars, but couldn't you maybe just give me a little sign or something? Hey, I'm not interested in any of that biblical stuff, you know, that heavy stuff. Just some kind of little sign, maybe a beam of light. Blue would be nice. Yeah, what about that? Does that sound all right? Oh, come on now. If you can make the earth in 7 days, you can give me a sign while I'm waiting.